Hello guys, today we're going to have a look at the top 10 90s movies that you probably haven't seen yet. In today's world with Netflix, HBO, Binge, Amazon and the list goes on, there are so many viewing options in TV and movies yet, we still run out of quality movies to watch. And it's hard to know what's worth our time, so sit back and take a look at 10 of the best from a time when movies were becoming big business and mostly the stunts and the special effects were done for real. The stories had meaning. All these movies in our list are by no means low-budget movies and all have big names in the leading roles. But didn't quite make the big time as such movies like The Die Hards and The Lethal Weapons. And just went a little under the radar, and with so many younger people not even born when these gems came out, you may have missed them. So without further delay, we begin our list at number 10 with One False Move starring Bill Paxton and Billy Bob Thornton. So sit back and enjoy our top 10 movies from the 90s you probably haven't seen. Okay guys, here we go with One False Move. Billy Bob Thornton is an absolute psychopath in this movie, bashing women for info when his current girlfriend helps him gain access into a friend's little drug house to get the location of the drug dealer they get their drugs from and move up the list. With the help of his more mature killer who just seems to enjoy killing random people, and his girlfriend trying to keep things from escalating as she's stuck in between her crazy boyfriend and her friends telling them to just tell him what he wants to know and it'll be over. Little does she know what Billy Bob has planned.
Hey man, I got everything you want on the table over there. It's $200 in a wallet. Take it.
You know what? I hate that to fuck up.
There's some coke in the kitchen, man. Take the money and a coke.
This is lighter fluid, brother.
Shit, man.
Fuck this here. I'm gonna fuck her up. I don't want your little $200.
Take the money, man.
Fuck you, man. I don't want your $200. I don't want no $200.
Stop it, man.
Stop it.
Put it out. Put it out, man. Put your shit out. I'll tell you what it's shit. I'll tell you what it's shit.
Fuck you, man.
Put it out.
Fuck you.
So they find the drugs and cash and they kill everybody at both houses in pretty brutal fashion. They don't want to leave any witnesses and I think they just fucking like killing people. And leave and get a motel room for the night and the two baddie alphas get into an argument and here we meet Bill Paxton, rest in peace you legend, who is a small town sheriff in a little town who thinks all his Christmases have come at once as the FBI is in town looking for the baddies from early and his life has some excitement now.
No ma'am.
Well, what the fuck did you stop us for then?
Okay, now ma'am.
Yes, baby. Yes,
so now they're messing with more drug dealers and the body count keeps rising. And again, his mate seems to have really been enjoying himself a little too much. And here's Bill Paxton saying no to some good times, which happens a lot in the movies, but in real life I think that dude says, yeah, why not? And now Paxton is trying to take down these bad mothers on his own, but stupidly looks away and all hell breaks loose. He's definitely out of his depth, with more dead bodies piling up, but you'll have to watch the movie to see how it all ends.
Get your hands up, goddammit! I'll blow your fucking head off!
Okay guys, in at number 9 is Jade, that definitely went under the radar. Think Bruce Willis's Striking Distance, also from the 90s, and then throw in one of the best, most original car chases, and this is what you end up with. Starring Michael Biehn from The Rock, and David Caruso from NYPD and Kiss of Death, Kevin Feige from K-9 and Another 48 Hours, Richard Crenna from the first three Rambo movies, and Chaz Palmieri from The Usual Suspects, and Linda Florentino from Men in Black. And you have a decent cast with a madman serial type killer on the loose that you have to try to guess their identity. You have an awesome movie on your hands.
Congratulations.
Thank you. You never had a sexual relationship with him.
What the hell kind of question is that, David?
Michael Biehn from Terminator and Aliens is always welcome in my book, as is the sexy stuff, and there's plenty of that in this movie. But now we get down to the serious stuff, and I always remembered thinking how brutally awesome this rundown of the girl is in this scene. And if you can guess who's driving the black car of death, you've guessed who the killer is. And here we get one of the most awesome car chases at high speed, with jumps of at least 20 feet, which can only be in the streets of San Francisco. That ends up being the slowest chase in movie history when they drive their cars through Chinatown during a massive celebration, which is awkward to watch as you feel Caruso's pain of getting away from the crowd that wants his head. Shit. There's plenty of reasons to watch this movie, and back in 1995, I don't recall this movie going to Australian movie theatres, but it should have. I just remember one day seeing this on my local Blockbuster video store shelf, and just from the movie cover going to myself, ooh, what's this? Not knowing I was about to watch an unknown gem. So I know there's a lot of people out there that definitely haven't seen Jade. So find it, hire it, stream it, or steal it, but do yourself a favour and watch this movie. You won't be disappointed as Jade turns up the heat to 10, and does an awesome job of hiding the killer's identity to the last 10 minutes. And oh, did I mention the car chase? And more of the sexy stuff. And even though it's been 15 years since I watched this, I always remembered how she's positioned on this wall, sitting on this guy's face. He seems to be enjoying his work.
Get the fuck out of here.
You introduced me to Jade.
In at number 8 is a thrilling drama action that was one of our biggest surprises of 1997, The Assignment. Starring Aidan Quinn, Donald Sutherland and Ben Kingsley, this movie was right up my alley back in the day and even included a Rocky-style training part that has Quinn learning to act like his doppelganger, international terrorist, so they can swap him out with the bad guy. Even bringing in the bad guy's ex-girl to teach Quinn how to fuck like the terrorist, and feeding him the same shit food throughout the movie to make him hate the same food as a terrorist. Not until he fully walks, talks, and acts and fucks like the bad Aidan Quinn can his training end. Ben Kingsley is one to get him there, and Donald Sutherland is hell-bent on catching Carlos and will do anything to make it happen. Quinn is quickly plucked from his family and life simply because he looks like Carlos and has training in the field, but nothing will prepare him for what he will need to do to bring down the smart and ruthless Carlos, who will stop at absolutely nothing to avoid capture. Quinn will soon hate everything about his mission and slowly will change even his demeanour as he kinda starts to turn into a bad guy himself, and will have to work hard to keep his demons at bay. With loads of action and plenty of awesome spy stuff, this movie grabs you from the second it starts and doesn't let go till the gripping final minutes. He heads overseas and starts to infiltrate the life of the man he will get a battle against. Carlos is so paranoid that even the love of his life is not trusted, and he disguises himself just to test her loyalty. Always time to get your fuck on as we get some sexy stuff going on. But is this Carlos or his counterpart? More action as he gets deeper in, and we always like a little car chase through some dingy little town as bullets fly and the body count climbs, and so does the tension and the action. No one is safe from Carlos as his paranoia sets in. His mission starts to affect his family life as Quinn beats the shit out of an arsehole dad at the kids' sporting event. Not to say that guy didn't deserve it, but please, not in front of the kids.
You don't move.
Eddie Murphy, Michael Wincott, and Michael Rapaport all star in at number 7 in this epic action film, Metro. It starts hard and the action flows fast and non-stop as we see Eddie Murphy trying to play a serious part as hostage negotiator Scott Roper. He kind of pulls it off, but he should probably stick to comedy action. Not to say that I don't love Eddie in this movie, but pay special attention throughout this movie to the bad guy, Michael Wincott's facial expressions, as he drives, fights, and argues his way through loads of messy situations, as Eddie Murphy works his ass off to stop him. Wincott is believable as a ruthless fuck everyone kind of attitude and brings terror to anyone that gets in his way, including hostages that are unlucky enough to be at the bank, getting money out probably to go piss up at the pub.
Drive it up right here, walks to the end of the block.
No!
Stop it, stop it.
Hey! Leave her alone! What? Leave her alone!
Think.
Hold your fire!
Here we get one awesome car chase again in the awesome San Francisco, which was also in the number 9 movie Jade, as the massive steep roads make for great stunts in a car chase, and once the tram gets involved, forget about it. If you look closely during this chase, particularly when Eddie's car is being pushed downhill stuck to the front of a tram, you can see Eddie Murphy and Rappaport have been swapped out for stuntmen, and if you look for these kind of things as I do, you'll see what I'm talking about. But then they use the footage from this movie with our stars and the stuntmen and also 1994 Speed movie in the 2000 piece of crap movie Epicenter. I was watching Epicenter back in the day and noticed they band-aided scenes from great movies into Epicenter. How fucking rude. His chase has a feel like you're watching the chase from Sean Connery and Nicolas Cage's epic action movie The Rock. As you get San Francisco, you get an awesome car chase and there's also a tram thrown into the mix.
There's an expression, when you think you're fucking them, they're fucking
them. Fuck you! You don't give a fuck! I don't give a fuck!
Eddie Murphy makes it personal, so Wincott returns a favor in kind by stealing someone's girlfriend and tying her up, so that if Eddie lets go of the lever, she'll be chopped into sushi. Luckily, Rappaport, our local badass sniper, lip reads, and Eddie Murphy gets him to help out so he can save his girl and get some sexy time later that night. But the baddie is still going and the final battle begins. Watch Wincott's face of enjoyment as Murphy rides his bonnet to a grueling finish that ends as it started, full on.
That's for me? Imagine me in some shit like that. You actually bought that for me?
It would look cute on your...
In at number 6, we have One Tough Bastard starring Brian Bosworth, who made two awesome movies, this and Stone Cold. Brian Bosworth, playing Sergeant John North, is happy in life until his wife and child are involved in an altercation at the local convenience store. Bruce Payne from Passenger 57 and Clifford Collins Jr. from another movie in this top 10 video are introduced to us, and Cliff, being a big actor now, was back then just starting off in his career and is killed off quick smart. After his wife and child are murdered, Bosworth seeks revenge on nothing short of an army of baddies that think they're at the top of the food chain, but will soon realise they fucked with the wrong sergeant.
I thought you were going to torture
her. I need my money now, alright?
You'll get your money when you get back with a smack.
Now, I need it now.
All right.
One Tough Bastard takes us on a journey of revenge for a man who has lost everything. And the more bad guys he gets rid of, the more scumbags he finds. As far as I'm concerned, the world's better off without them. In this Burning Man scene, this is a stuntman set on fire for real and makes for a powerful scene. This dickhead zigged when he should have zagged. Here's Jeff Kober playing Marcus, and he's pretty much always a bad guy, appearing in TV shows such as The Walking Dead and Sons of Anarchy, and many more. The baddies just keep piling up as there are many different players and groups that seem to get into Sergeant John North's way, and he'll kill everyone that does. Also dealing with a killer that's under federal protection and supposedly good guys getting in the way, no one else could take on this mammoth task but this guy who knows 150 ways to fuck up your day. So get this movie and watch it, and I promise you'll be glad you didn't upset Bosworth. Have you ever wanted to rob a bank, or base jump off a cliff, or just kill some cunt to see what it's like? Well, if you have, this movie is for you. These guys robbing this place have already done it, but one of them has a special rig on that allows someone else, later on, to play back the robbery where they will relive the robbery and feel the whole thing as if they'd done it themselves. For a price, you can do just about anything from the comfort of your lounge room. Everyone's going crazy as the movie is leading up to New Year's back in 2000, when the whole world thought we were goners because of the 2K panic that most of us remember, and throw two of the most desperate cops hunting a female that will stop at nothing to gun her down, and you're in for a real treat on this one. Strain Day stars Angela Bassett as badass, tough-as-fuck Lornette the Mace Mason from the Tina Turner movie, and Ralph Fiennes from Schindler's List, Juliette Lewis from Natural Born Killers, and yes, you see her tits on many occasions in this movie, and she just oozes sexy when she rocks out singing in this movie. Tom Sizemore stars from Pearl Harbor, and Michael Wincott from Number 7 on this video, Metro, as another awesome baddie, and you have to wonder why this movie wasn't bigger in its day. The question is, why do the two police want that girl dead so badly? And as the movie continues, you will be given more answers to why. The two cops in question are both massive actors, as one is Vincent D'Onofrio from Full Metal Jacket and Daredevil and loads more epic movies, and William Fichtner from Armageddon and Prison Break, and just too many classics to name them all. Pretty much every face you see in this movie, you will be like, I know that guy or girl from somewhere. Ralph Fiennes is former police turned hustler, and they find a conspiracy that will rock the foundations of the entire city.
I have to leave him alone if he'd stop coming around, and you would just stop talking to him.
Is this impact resistant?
Yeah, sure.
Also, throw in a very influential gangster rapper and a serial killer who loves his work that you can try and guess who the killer is. The build up to the gripping end will have you literally on the edge of your seat biting your nails. An awesome first grade action, and you won't believe that you've never seen this movie before. Fights are top notch, and the baddies will all grab your attention, as there's many kinds, and I've tried to hide any major plot points in this video, yet also giving you an awesome taste of what you get when you use your valuable time to track down this absolute gem of a movie. And that for 2 hours you'll be fully entertained with a star-studded cast and an awesome original story directed by Kathryn Bigelow, behind such movies like Zero Dark Thirty, The Hurt Locker, and the brutal vampire flick Near Dark. And you know you're about to see something very special that could have easily slipped into the number one spot on this video. So strap in, grab your mate or your missus and a big tub of popcorn, and watch this classic gem.